as a running example for today, I want to implement a little game played between Alice and Bob. It's a bit like rock, paper, scissors, but even simpler because there are only two options. So Alice and Bob both have two options. They can either play zero or one. And if they played it while being physically in the same room, it would be played just like rock, paper, scissors. So at the same time, they raise their hand and there's one gesture for zero and one gesture for one. And depending on what they play, one of them wins. So if they both use the same gesture, both choose zero or both choose one, then Alice wins. And if the choices are different, then Bob wins. Now let's imagine that Alice and Bob can't meet in person, but they still want to play the game. So they decide to play it via mail. Email or snail mail, doesn't matter. Of course, we will later implement it on the blockchain using Plutus. But how could that work? So Alice can send a mail with her choice, let's say zero, to Bob. But this, of course, gives a very unfair advantage to Bob because now he opens Alice's mail and sees she picked zero, and he can simply reply sending one, and he wins. And of course, if Alice instead picks one, Bob can simply choose zero. So Bob would always win, at least if he's unfair. So what can we do about that? And there's a very clever trick that's often used in cryptographic protocols, and that's about commit schemes. So the idea is that Alice doesn't reveal her choice to Bob, but she commits to it so that she later can't change her mind. And one way to make that work is using hash functions. I mean, hashes are all over the place in the blockchain world. I mean, we have seen that, for example, addresses, script addresses are just the hash of the Plutus core script. And we have seen lots of examples of using public key hashes and so on. And what hash functions are, they are so-called one-way functions. So it's difficult or impossible, given a hash, to reconstruct the original document or the original byte string that was hashed to this hash. So one way we could try to make this work is that instead of sending her choice to Bob, she instead sends the hash of her choice to Bob. So she sends the hash of zero, which is just some, I don't know, cryptic byte string. So now Bob sees this cryptic byte string and he has no idea whether Alice picked zero or one. So he maybe picks zero and there's no need for him to use a hash. So he can just send the zero in clear text. And so now Alice would have won, but maybe Bob doesn't believe her. So there's then one additional step that Alice has to send another message to Bob where she now sends her actual choice. And then what Bob has to do is he has to check whether hash of Alice's claimed choice is indeed the hash he received earlier. And if it is, then he knows that Alice is not lying and that she indeed picked zero and that he lost. But if this hash doesn't match up, then he knows she's cheating or trying to cheat, and he would win. And of course, if Alice instead picked one, that would work exactly the same, except that the hash would be different. So this sounds promising, but there's one big problem with this, because in this game there are only two choices, only zero and one. So there are only two possible hashes. They may look very cryptic to Bob the first time they play, but I mean, sooner or later he'll notice that he always sees one of these two hashes, and then he knows which choice Alice made. And that's almost as bad as if she directly sent her choice out in the open. But what we can do here is that Alice doesn't simply send the hash of zero, but that she first concatenates zero with some arbitrary byte string, so-called nonce, that she picks. So the way this would work is first Alice picks a nonce, some arbitrary text, and then she sends the hash of the nonce and her choice. For example, 0 to Bob, which is some other cryptic byte string. And now it's not always the same byte string if she picks 0, provided she always chooses some random unpredictable nonce. So Bob receives that and then it proceeds as before. So he sends his choice, for example, 0. And now in the third message, Alice has to not only reveal her original choice, but she has to send the nonce as well. So in this case, she would send the nonce and 0. And then Bob checks that hash of Alice's claimed nonce concatenated with 0 is indeed the hash he originally received. And if it is, he knows he lost. And if it is not, then he knows she tried to cheat him. So this works very nicely. And this is what we will try to implement in Plutus on Cardano. So first, we'll use what we have seen so far. And then we'll see how, by using state machines, the code can be much clearer and much shorter. Now, what will this look like? So first, Alice opens the game by posting the hash of her nonce combined with the choice she makes to play. So we have the hash. Then, if Bob plays along, he will post his own choice. So Bob will play. And now we have the hash and Bob's choice. Let's call it C Bob. If at this point Alice realizes that she has won, depending on Bob's choice, she can reveal her secret and the game ends and she has won. Let's assume that when Alice plays and when Bob plays, they both put down a certain amount of money. And in this scenario where Alice has won, Alice gets Bob's claim and her own back. If, however, after Bob made his move, Alice sees that she has lost, there's no need actually for her to do anything because she has lost anyway. So after a certain deadline has been reached, and Alice just doesn't reply, and then Bob claims his win. And there's another option that we haven't considered it. It could be that after Alice starts playing, Bob simply is not interested and doesn't reply. So in that case, there must be a way for Alice to get her own money back. And that's basically all the things that can happen. So the different stages of the game starts by Alice opening with the hash of the concatenation of her nonce and her move. Then if Bob doesn't reply, Alice gets her money back. If Bob does reply, he puts down his choice. And then there are two possibilities again. Alice realizes she has won and she needs to prove it to Bob by revealing and she wins, or she doesn't do anything and after some time has passed, Bob can claim the win and he gets both Alice's and his own stake. So let's implement this in Plutus now. First, just using the techniques we already know about.